I am Dr. Jesse John, Assistant Professor, Department of Anatomy, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. So today we are discussing anatomy of spleen and some general features, surface and boundaries. And so we will discuss here continuously. Spleen is the largest lymphoid organ in the body, and we call it hemolymphoid organ. And the main function of the spleen are to filter blood by removing worn out RBCs and microbial agents from the circulation, to manufacture RBCs in fetal life and lymphocytes after birth, to provide immunity to the body by producing immunoglobulin M by plasma cells, to store RBCs and release them in circulations when it is required. Location: the spleen is located in the left hypochondrium between the fundus of the stomach and the diaphragm, behind the axillary line, opposite the 9th, 10th and 11th ribs. The long axis lies parallel to the long axis of the 10th rib. It moves a bit in living during respiration. So we can see here in these locations, it is almost at the end of the pancreatic tail. Size, shape and color: the spleen is a wedge shaped soft organ with purple color. The size of the spleen roughly corresponds to the first according to the shape and form. According to the shape and form, the spleen is classified into three types: wedge-shaped, that is the most common, 44%, and tetrahedral, that is the 42%, and the most uncommon is triangular, that is the 14%. Measurement of the spleen are: the thickness of the spleen is 1 inch, and width of the spleen is 3 inch, and length is 5 inches, and weight 7 ounces. Surface projection: the spleen is marked on the surface on the left side of the back of the trunk. Its long axis corresponds to that of the 10th rib. Its upper border corresponds to the upper border of the 9th rib, and its lower border corresponds to the lower border of the 11th rib. Its medial end lies about 5 cm from the posterior midline of the body, at the level of the spine of T10 vertebra, and lateral end at the mid axillary line. External surface: these some things that present at the external features, that are the two ends, that is the anterior and posterior, and three borders, that superior, inferior and intermediate borders, and two surface, that is diaphragmatic and visceral surfaces. And we can see here in this picture the superior and inferior border and the visceral surface. The visceral surface means that they correspond to the viscera, and diaphragmatic surface, it means the surface correspond to the diaphragm. And these are two ends, anterior and posterior end. Anterior end is broad and is more like a border, and it is directed downwards and forward and to the left. It is related to the left colic flexor in the front and the phrenic colic ligament below. The posterior end is blunt and rounded, and it is directed upward, backward and medially towards the vertebral column, and it is related to the upper pole of the left kidney. Border: superior border, the superior border is thin and convex. It separates the visceral surface from the diaphragmatic surface. It characteristically presents 1 and 2 notches near its anterior end. These notches indicate that the spleen develops by the fusion of the separate masses of the lymphoid tissue, and these are present in the development of the spleen. Inferior border: the inferior border separates the visceral surface from the diaphragmatic surface. It is rounded and corresponds to the lower border of the 11th rib. Intermediate order: the intermediate border is rounded and separates the gastric impression from the renal impression or the visceral surface. And these are the surface. Diaphragmatic surface is smooth, convex, and directed upward, backward, and to the left. And visceral surface is concave and irregular. It presents four impressions: gastric, renal, and colic pancreatic. So these are structures. These are the organs that present on the surface. So there will be impressions on the splenic surface. The gastric impression is produced by the fundus of the stomach, and it is the largest impression and lies between the superior and intermediate border. The hilum of the spleen is located in lower part of this impression. A renal impression is produced by the left kidney and lies below and behind the gastric impressions, between the intermediate and inferior borders. The colic impression is produced by the left colic flexure, and it is triangular in shape and situated in front of the lateral end. And the pancreatic impression is produced by the tail of the pancreas, and it is located between the hilum and the colic impressions. And the relations. Peritoneal relations. The spleen is completely enclosed in peritoneum except at its hilum, from where two peritoneal folds extends on, one to the stomach and one to the left kidney, and these called gastrosplenic and linorenal ligaments respectively. Gastrosplenic ligament extends from the hilum of the spleen to the upper one third of the greater curvature of the stomach, and it contains short gastric vessels. Linorenal ligament extends from the hilum of the spleen to the anterior surface of the left kidney, and it contains the tail of the pancreas, splenic vessels, and pancreatosplenic lymph nodes. And the visceral relation is related to the sum of the visceras we have discussed earlier, that is the fundus of the stomach, anterior surface of the left kidney, left colic flexure, and tail of the pancreas. And these visceras produce impression of the surface, and the diaphragmatic surface of the spleen is related to the diaphragm, which separates it from the costophrenic recesses of the pleura, lung, and 9 to 11th ribs. And rest of the part of the spleen we will discuss in next video.